social determinants of health is just a complicated balloon. It represents where we're born, what our socioeconomic class is, what education is available and that we have, what grocery stores are around the corner, what our work options are. So it's really the whole package. Where you live, the community, the zip code where you live, is a big determinant of how old you're gonna be, how long you're gonna live here.
How do we look at the years of living in this particular area, 67 years, and 8 miles down the road to the west of us is 86 years, a difference of almost 20 years. This particular area, there is no YMCA. There is no facility that they can go into. It's a food desert as well. It takes more than just the people who live in this community. It takes all of our agencies involved in order to see that we need to make some improvements in this particular area and into other areas that show that we have social determinants of health.
Part of the issue when you don't have transportation or your transportation is very limited, then you have to walk. So if I'm walking, where am I going to go to get food? And how am I going to get it from point A to point B? So if I'm walking and I can go to the dollar store, I can go to the corner store and just pick up a small amount of things, that's going to be easier when I'm walking versus having to go and pick up a whole lot of groceries. And so I think that's one of the factors that a lot of people don't think about. The cost in buying onesies versus being able to buy, you know, a huge package of chicken and divide it up over several days is a factor for a lot of people.
So the difference between life expectancy and healthy life expectancy is like New York to San Diego. Because none of us really are interested in getting old. No one has ever told me that, hey, I want to just live more. It's just, I want to have quality of life. As a cardiologist, what I admire about the American Heart is that they're impacting from the research that we do for heart attacks. So there's the research piece if someone's having cardiac disease. There's that huge piece that the American Heart Association does for women and heart disease. And I think they're focused on children.
If we can change the living conditions, we can change a life itself. If we could look at those determinants that are affecting the health of our community, and if we make those changes all over the city, we are creating longevity of health for all citizens and not just for a few.
If you have a healthy community, then you have a voting community, you have a spending community, you have a community that loves where they live. As we begin to be more healthy, as we begin to have a healthier lifestyle, then we can contribute more to the whole of making Wichita a great place to be.
Wichita can be a model for the rest of the United States of how to solve or minimize this disparity. Martin Luther King, he said that human progress is neither automatic or inevitable, that it requires the tireless exertions and passionate concerns of dedicated individuals. Let's be those dedicated individuals. It would make Wichita proud.